Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the Royal London Theatre here in London, England. Our main event should be a good one tonight. 10 rounds among heavyweights. We are looking forward to this fight, especially after seeing what happened at the weigh-in yesterday. A stare down that nearly resulted in. Now they get to do it for real. Fighter just as much a mentality as it is a physical strategy and style.
Yeah, I think it's a confidence. I think it's an identity that you embrace, that this is my home and this is where I'm going to go live. This is what I do for a living.
And now he's targeting upstairs. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Joe Frazier. Landed a good solid combination.
Body shot. Connect yourself.
Keeping his hands up, getting rid of his opponent's offense. Takes one to get one. He comes back with a right hand. Excellent 1-2 by Joe Frazier. Halfway through this round. Job with the left hand. It was sudden and fast, and it was direct by Evander Holyfield. Evander Holyfield's putting forth a great combination now. And now he scores well with a straight right. Good step back. Defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Good job on the two-punch combo by Joe Frazier. Final 10 seconds of round number one. And that's the end of round one. Evander Holyfield showing off a real boxing IQ in that last round. Just fighting him smart. I mean, not just reckless aggression, smart, accurate punching.
And talking about IQs, it's being led by that left jab, an educated left jab. A jab that talks a little bit, talks a couple languages. I mean, he's hooking off it, he's uppercutting off it, he's doubling up on it. Good job.
Locks the headshot. Frazier's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Big uppercut right on the mark.
Come on, baby!
Move away from the ropes! Now you gotta see that coming. Let's go! Swing back!
Holyfield's able to land a good, solid left hand. Frustrating his opponent with great defense. Nicely timed 1-2. There's the headshot, but he parries it away. Right to the belt line. Unable to make an impact there by Evander Holyfield.
Come on!
There's the combo to the body. First 2 minutes of these rounds. Now these fighters are trying to make everybody a believer in the final 60 seconds.
And this is why you understand the dimension of this sport like no other sport. At the end of this, how both participants will have mutual great respect for each other.
Come on. Holyfield's on the receiving end of a a very good coverage. Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Evander Holyfield. Frazier's commitment to the cause of being the aggressor really helped in front of the last round. Look at his opponent. Is underway.
Move.
Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Jab and a straight right by Joe Frazier. And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own. Nice block that time. It was intended to the head. Took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand.
Keep it going.
Oh, good exchange there. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well. Good defensive guard now by Evander Holyfield. Trying to erode away that body with the combination punching.
Tell the story, but in this case, he's been the busier man, throwing more punches.
Yeah, but he's also had to do a lot more work just to keep his opponent off, just to keep him defensive. Does that hurt him as the fight goes on?
A three-punch combination scores. Nice work by Joe Frazier. Going to the body there. He digs in, trying to bank away body shots with the combo. Nice strike after pitching one by Evander Holyfield.
He's doing what he's doing.
How about a return to center with the left hand? Holyfield's failure to protect himself from that left hand, it's become a big story now.
Yeah, and he has to understand why. He's not controlling distance. He's standing too close in front. Needs to adjust a little further out.
Huge left hand from Smokin' Joe. Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Oh, and the right hand comes into play by Joe Frazier. Frazier's showing you what it takes to be the best in this business. Good, crisp combos. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. To the body. Joe Frazier's right hand scores well that time. And that's the end of round four. Listen, he's a veteran guy. He knows the situation. That's a really bad cut.
No need to get
it. He has a gamble right now. You know, just got last call in the casino. They just said, you know, you got three more rolls of the dice. He's got to roll him. He's got to blow on him. He's got to do everything.
Well, his opponent is opening up and coming forward, so I would think there are some opportunities on the fist.
Yeah, I think some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end.
Unload! More punches!
Oh, you see him with the left of the head there? Great work offensively, landing that combination by Joe Frazier. He tried to nab up top, but was unable to connect. Took a shot, now he gets a left. A snapping combination by Joe Frazier. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. A minute and a half to go.
Don't let him get to you, kid.
Nice combination by Joe Frazier. Frazier's putting forth that hard work. He got caught by that right hand. He never saw it coming. He may be looking to clinch here. Oh, and there he lands the right hand well. Oh, a big shot. He goes down. It may be close here. Can he survive the round? Holyfield's going to keep taking this test, rising up. Oh, boy, what a break he just caught. The bell rings at the end of the round, saved by the bell.
And if you're in the corner, what do you do? Well, you just finished painting the house, you know? You want to paint a little more, but the paint is still wet. You got to wait for it to dry a little bit. You got to wait for your guy to wake up. You got to wait for the cobwebs to go away before you can do more painting.
Underway for what is the second half of this fight. Who knows what we're in store for? Gets rid of that body shot. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Joe Frazier. Frazier's ability to properly throw and land his combinations has been stunning. Teddy, why is he so successful?
Because you just said it. He's putting them together. You know, one or two wouldn't land, but he's handcuffing the guy. And the first two punches, they set up the third and fourth.
Good work defensively by Evander Holyfield. Plus, he landed that.
Yeah, and he forced him to punch. He made him. He drew it out of him. And then he timed him beautifully.
Unable to land clean by Evander Holyfield. Frazier's doing well, sticking to a game plan on the outside. Holyfield's got a little something coming back at him, a counterpunch score. Frazier showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Oh, that's good stuff. Fired right back with one of his own. Good work by Joe Frazier. Guts it takes, what commitment it takes to keep up with this kind of a pace. The action's been nonstop.
Now, the one thing I can tell you is this is where you don't worry about pace. You don't think about pace. Otherwise, you could not be doing what these guys are doing. They're just going round to round.
And round six comes to an end. Joe Frazier's in dominating form here tonight. He's doing everything he wanted to do. And he's ahead on our scorecard to ringside.
Yeah, but don't forget, he's in the other guy's hometown. So don't let up too soon. Don't start partying too soon. You know, still keep doing the things you were doing to get you to this place.
fighter coming back with the right hand after getting scored upon. Frazier's combination punching is working well here. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Hits him in the mug with the right. With that headshot. Yeah. Evander Holyfield's gone into a defensive shell, but that shell has cracks in it.
Yeah, it does, and the reason why it's getting cracked is because his opponent is confident that with those earmuffs on, you know, going into that peek-a-boo defense that he is, he knows he's handcuffed, so he's putting together these four or five punches where normally he would only throw one or two, worried something's going to come back.
Right back to the gut. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand score.
Watch that.
Well, we heard the stories coming into this fight that he worked extra hard in the gym. Now you're seeing the payoff, Teddy. Your scorecard through seven rounds has him up big.
Well, we heard about him working those 5 minute rounds instead of the traditional 3 minute rounds, and it's showing. It's paying for him, as you just said.
Off the right!
Fine combo there. Right hand followed by the left hook. Frazier's going well with the hook on the inside again. But Teddy, I'm looking at it saying, I can't believe nothing's coming back at him. There's got to be the opportunity there to counter that, right?
There is an opportunity, especially because he's taking a picture a little bit. You know, he's looking at what he does. He keeps doing that, so Flair's going to
Evander Holyfield's down. He's going to have to beat the count. Down he goes, but he's going to continue on, beating the count. That is boxing 101. A nice, crisp combination by Joe Frazier. Big, big shot comes crashing home.
Evander Holyfield's got to beat the count, but I don't think he has it in him.
He beats the count again. Teddy, I've heard you say it time and time again. Too tough for his own good. Holyfield's done it again. Another head clash here. That headbutt is going to cost him. The referee is deducting a point, saying that was intentional.
Body shot, body shot.
Defensive guard of Joe Frazier there. Well played, straight right hand. Frazier's so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. What a difference with the corner to corner as he sits on his stool. He knows that he is in complete control of this fight, peppering his opponent with power shots.
Well, it's been like that all night long. Anything he throws finds a target.
Evander Holyfield's corner is probably wondering what the answer is.
No!
so far, they haven't had it. Starting yet another round, coming off yet another round. When he was down, sets up that right hand for the jab. Holyfield's going to get a point deduction here for that clash of heads. The referee now feels that it's purposeful what he's doing, and he's deducting a point. Nice block by Joe Frazier. Frazier scoring very well with the uppercut. What could his opponent be doing to defend against it better?
Well, if he sees that hand drop a little bit instead of the shoulder tipping, if you drop that hand to throw the uppercut, there could be an opening, and he should look for that with the hook. Counter right back. That hand drops, bang, beat him to the mark with the hook.
Good evening, everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Glad you're back in action, and welcome you to Boardwalk Hall at the famed Atlantic City Boardwalk in southern New Jersey for a much-anticipated main event. 10 rounds of heavyweight action. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. Looking at making his way down to the ring. You can just see it in every step that he takes. His ring walk is one of those ring walks where you realize how attentive this fighter is. This is a guy who has his eye on the prize and nothing. we are underway here, and as we've talked about it going into this fight, and you really touched on this, Teddy, the biggest edge comes with him in terms of his speed advantage.
Yeah, not just with his hands, though. Downstairs with his feet, too.
A little 1-2. Jab followed by the cross.
That's gone all right. Survive the round, get your head clear, you're gonna win the other round.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Solid straight right hand. The old 1-2 scores for him. For this moment and rise up and continue on. And Muhammad Ali looks across as if to say, ain't no thing. He was knocked down, but he's far from out. There. Two snapping jabs by Muhammad Ali.
Get your hands up.
Scored well upstairs with the right hand. Muhammad Ali blocks that punch. A target on his head, and he places the hook right on it. End of the round. A round in which a knockdown was scored. Now, Teddy, if you're the trainer, in the corner of the guy scoring the knockdown, what are some of the things you want to remind him of?
You want to remind him how he got there, because a lot of times it's a tendency to just remember the punch that put him there. He dressed him up. He set that punch up. Don't think about just the punch that landed. Think about the setup punch.
Good shot there with that left. Teddy, you talk about going out and making a few opening statements here. The jab has spoken loudly.
Yeah, it has spoken loudly, but it's told his opponent.
The
United just sort of walk You're not coming into my house. It's going to be hard. I got a couple locks, a couple padlocks on you.
Keep your distance.
Muhammad Ali. It's lucky that the referee didn't see that. I can't believe he just got away with a headbutt.
And there he is, scoring with the right hand. Coming to the halfway point of this third round.
He has his target. He lands a straight right. And now a little combination punching, landing both shots. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Muhammad Ali. Right hand downstairs. He just missed that shot up top. Good fundamental work landing the 1-2 there. Good looking right hand after he got hit. Oh, and there you go. Absolutely out of nowhere to now on top of the world. He just floored him with that punch.
Short one, maybe 6 inches.
What do you think, Teddy? Do you think he can survive things here? He's been down multiple times now and keeps getting up.
Gracie tells us that fighters, when they're pushed to the brink, they find a way sometimes, but not always.
This is like a bull seeing red right now.
He has the hope now that the bull gets a little over anxious and runs right into a short. Or straight, I think.
And that's the end of round of three.
This is turning into a wasted effort here as we reflect on the first three rounds and get a chance to look at Teddy's scorecard. Yes, he's throwing punches, but nothing's landing. He's down on his scorecard 3-0.
He's wide open every time he throws. And he's getting toward counter, especially that right hand, right up the middle.
Nice! Nice!
Carries that punch intended for the head. Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here?
Well, two aspirin and then... Oh, no. Actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor ordered.
That's a better prescription. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. Well, that's exactly what he deserves. The ref getting involved, warning him for the headbutt. Nice combination, landing more than one. Both were able to score. Seconds to go in round number four. Ali's got a way of just getting away from that punch. Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. Throwing more than one, both scored there.
Keep working them up.
Little head knocking with that right hand. Punches and punches. Worked out well there with that combo.
Yeah, you know, the early punches set up the late punches.
Scores well to the head. To be out.
Now we're gonna see what's inside this man.
So the early action here in this fight should reveal an edge. Holyfield's got speed. He can move.
Well, they say speed kills. He better just be careful he doesn't have an accident. He doesn't get reckless with that speed.
Keep your hands up.
Come on, baby.
That is exactly what the corner wanted to see. A good combination punch by Evander Holyfield. Very nice defensive guard there. Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. I like that step back right there. Just enough to be out of danger, but still close enough to then land the counter.
Well, that's what happens when you have that kind of experience. It's hard enough to know that range. Know where the beginning of the punch and the end of the punch is.
Rushing two-punch combo by Evander Holyfield. Holyfield's well off the mark that time. A solid uppercut by Evander Holyfield. Ali's knowledge of the game is showing through. Three ways to defend, one of them is the block. He did it there well. Missed by a mile. That wasn't even close by Muhammad Ali. Unbelievable pace here tonight. Both guys have no plans of having this fight go far. I'm sure the frame of reference for most is Hatler.
Yeah, you wonder if it's going to live up to that. So far, so good.
Ali's defensive flaws in that last round were very, very costly. He's not doing a good enough job of simply protecting himself.
No, I'm not sure that he knows how.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Well-placed hook from Ali. Committed to go into the gut. That's an impactful right hand by Evander Holyfield. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Evander Holyfield's missing the mark by a mile. That just was nowhere to be found. Halfway through round number two. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Good solid 1-2 by Muhammad Ali. But he came back with a right hand of his own. Ali's defense is paying off now. And once again, he returns fire up top. Countdown, the final moments of this round. Zoning in on that gut combination punch downstairs. And that's the end of round two. Holyfield's really impressing us here tonight. That last round, boy, he was on top of his game and all over his opponent, laid out some serious damage there.
Yeah, I noticed that he's starting to land that uppercut a little bit. The only thing that I wouldn't be satisfied with what he did the last time, I was just looking for him for confidence to do more as sort of a good roadmap to maybe even get a knockout victory here. Put something on top of those uppercuts. You know the uppercut's landing. Now put something up top.
Good, clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Muhammad Ali. Defensively protecting the head. Scores up top with a left. Good block. Evander Holyfield's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Missed the body shot. That's a well-scored left hand by Evander Holyfield. Putting his punches together now. That's a nice combination. Come on. Flush right hand to the head. Holyfield's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Well-timed right hand by Muhammad Ali. He's showing what a skilled fighter he is with the kick.
Well, the old time teachers say when you're calm in there, when you're controlling there, you can make him do what you want. He made him tie his shoelaces right there.
Holyfield's at his best when the combinations are landing. He scored well there with that combo. Well, we heard his analysis, but as for how Teddy has scored those first three rounds, here's a look. Teddy, there are opportunities that are here for him, aren't there?
Yeah, counterpunch opportunities, because he's got an opponent who's walking in a little bit. Now he has a chance to start to chuck something back at him a little.
Combination.
Keep moving around the ring.
Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Nice two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. Holyfield's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Now, this is just beautiful to watch. Watch how he just links one to the next, Teddy. A beautiful sequence, almost like musical notes being played.
Well, exactly. It's a nice tool because it just follows. One, as you said, follows the other. Nice and smooth.
10 seconds remaining in this round.
To slug it out with this guy, all right? Keep your range. Jab, jab, right, okay?
Round number 5 has arrived. Oh, he just misses with that headshot.
Come on, kid.
Tough target there. He gets away from that punch. Nice jab there by Evander Holyfield. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Evander Holyfield. Ali's showing a little bit of a defensive shot. shell, but Teddy, I'm seeing punches still getting through and splitting that guard.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, Joe, when you put those earmuffs on, but you don't move your head. Some of them are going to get through, and just as importantly, your hands up yourself, so your opponent is going to stay in there a little bit longer, knowing that nothing's coming back right away.
Right there. Good 1-2 by Evander Holyfield. Holyfield's coming up with the answer, avoiding that punch. Just 10 seconds to go in this round. The end of round five. Holyfield's in a position now where he should be able to bring home a win. If things stay the way they are, he's clearly headed towards a win.
Yeah, I have him ahead on my scorecard, but he has to make sure he doesn't, like in football, go into that defense. If he starts just moving, just staying away a little bit, now the things that were keeping his opponent from coming in that front door, well, guess what? They're not there no more. His opponent could get back into this fight.
Good block by Muhammad Ali. Keep nice moving, two-punch combo moving. By Evander Holyfield.
Luke gets up.
His opponent wanted the body. He wouldn't give it to him. Counters with a crushing blow to the head. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Here's one for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand. Evander Holyfield's jab continues to carry the day. He's wanted it. He's got it. Good combination to the body. Halfway through round six. Oh, a good right hand by Evander Holyfield. Muhammad Ali is showing you that sublime skill right now. Good right hand. Well, his opponent got away from that uppercut.
Keep it going. Yeah.
He missed with that headshot. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Nice strike after catching one by Evander Holyfield. Last 10 seconds. So he puts forth another punishing display. Evander Holyfield's dominating this fight from start to finish, and the end is getting near.
And his opponent's looking like he's got Everlast written on his forehead. I mean, he looks like a bag.
Good job with another left hand. Not able to connect with the uppercut. Able to dismiss that body shot. Punching is working well here. Holyfield's defense did a good job there, able to avoid that punch. Able to cover up that gut. Oh, what an exchange! Ali's so dangerous with that action. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. He returns the favor with an uppercut. Well-placed body shot again. Unable to get to Ali. Ali blocked it. gives him the warning for the headbutt. Good block by Evander Holyfield. More than one punch downstairs. That could be damaging. Yeah. Holyfield's going to think about the next time he throws a punch because he just got hit by a good solid counter. 3 minutes gone by in this round.
Start of round number 8 right here. Teddy, this is very much a one-sided fight.
Maybe the opponent's best chance is to go back to history. LaMotta and Dottil. LaMotta was so far behind going into the last round that he had no shot except by a knockout. And what he did was he played positive a little bit. Tipped his legs a little bit. Went back towards the rope. And he got Dottil to come in, get a little careless. Bang, he pulled it out.
Targeted two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. Evander Holyfield's defense, is it ever good? Look at how easy he's able to block those punches. Ali's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Evander Holyfield swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent. His opponent is having a field day, Teddy. That left hand lands again.
Well, he keeps moving the wrong direction. He needs to move away from that punch.
He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Evander Holyfield.
Technique, and that is why he's right on the mark.
Oh, a nice two-punch combo by Muhammad Ali. This round comes to an end. And you can just see that he doesn't have much to him, not much energy there. How does a trainer fix that?
Well, first of all, you said a key word there. You said you can just see. Well, his opponent can see it, so he's not going to slow down. His opponent now is going to come out even faster. So if you're the trainer, the first thing you say is, hey, take a deep breath, get yourself together. Don't let this guy know you're tired. You're not tired.
Work right there, landing the two punches in sequence by Muhammad Ali. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Muhammad Ali.
Move away from the ropes.
Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. Targeting that midsection now with the combo. They trade shots. He comes back with a right hand.
Yeah.
10 seconds to go in this, the final round. One-sided outing.
Well, this one is easy to score. At least it should be.
Let's hear how the judges had it. A well-deserved win by Vander Holyfield. Unanimous decision.
You can have your eyes closed and see that one. They're almost there.
Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us, everyone. Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas welcoming you to the New York City Arena here in Midtown Manhattan for our main event of the evening. 10 rounds in the heavyweight division. Great atmosphere here tonight. You talk to every... for 10.
A lot of guys are intimidated when they face Mike Tyson before the opening bell even rings. But tonight he's going up against a counterpuncher, a guy that can't take that attitude, a guy that's got to be patient, he's got to be smart, he's got to make this a chess match.
Yeah, and a guy who's going to take advantage of those things that we don't always look at when we're watching Tyson as weaknesses. We just look at the, you know, we just look at the good parts. We just look at the parts that catch our attention that we're fascinated about. Yeah, he's finishing a guy where he's landing with his perfect blow. But before it gets to that point, there's a lot of open air. There's a lot of opportunity. There's a lot of space. He throws a punch. He leaves himself wide open. And wide open means that a counterpunch is going to have an opportunity. He's going to have a chance.
Halfway through round number one. Nice block by Johnson. Tyson with a powerful left hand. Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Nice block by Johnson.
He's hearing a little tweeting going on, a little singing from the birds in his head.
Johnson's recovered nicely here, the start of this round, and he is proving to me at least that what happened in that last round is having no effect on this round. Well timed by Mike Tyson. Took a step back, landed the counter punch.
Exactly what he wanted to do.
Mike Tyson's putting his punches together now. That's a nice combination. Nice defense. Good block by Johnson.
Don't let him get to you, kid.
Johnson's defense is now serving him well. Nice job blocking that part. Landing two jabs by Mike Tyson. There's a straight right hand. Was it that obvious right from the start that this physical specimen that you were seeing as a 12, 13, 14-year-old was going to end up being the pro fighter we're seeing in the ring now?
Well, Costamato, the first day we had in the gym, said to me, you're going to have a chance maybe to train your first heavyweight champ if this guy stays interested, if he gives us a chance to develop him.
Circle!
And now the ref gets involved and warns him for headbutting. A strategy here tonight, Teddy. So many times, it's, hey, I'm gonna bang that drum.
Yeah, he is banging that drum. That drum happens to be the body. And he figures that he's gonna try to move on him, so start doing it early on, and later on, he's gonna have a guy in front of him.
Johnson's proving that he's here to fight. Just look at the punch.
Got it. He's out.
Here you go.
Number three is underway. Good effective work with that straight right hand. Took a shot, now he gets a left. Zones in on that overhand right. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Throw it off the
defense. You drop down and bang.
Chance to look at the scorecards, and Teddy, you like what he's done so far early. A clean sweep of all three rounds.
Yeah, a couple of rounds were close, but on the inside, when both of them had their chance to separate a little bit, he was the one who made the right decision to punch.
Tyson's out there for another round after being knocked down in the last round. We know what happens in the 60 seconds for the fighter. Big right hand. He turned things around. Did you see? By this, once again, he hits the deck.
He's gonna have to find a way.
He has shown some guts in getting up yet again, but now he may need a little bit of luck to survive.
Well, he's gonna need a little bit of a clinch. He might need crazy glue to just get in close and make sure that he locks onto his opponent.
Boxing 101, jab followed by the straight. Comes right back at him with a left hand.
Keep your head moving.
And he returns on that exchange. Johnson's done a good job there, offensively scoring with that left hand. Committing to the body work with the double jab. Tyson starting to bleed from the nose. His corner should be wary of that. He's got bad intentions.
Well, he should feel the effects. I mean, look, Joe, it's kind of like standing out in a rainstorm with an umbrella, and all of a sudden the wind's coming, and the rain's coming from the side, and you're standing there under the umbrella and saying, why am I getting wet? Or you're standing there covering up, the punches are coming from the side, they're coming from all angles. You're going to get wet.
You're not always protected. Well, that's yet another round that he won, and Teddy, he's in great shape. What were you hearing out of his training camp as to how he got so conditioned?
Well, we were hearing that he was doing his best.
Johnson's not going to get away with this here. That headbutt, the referee is saying that was an intentional foul, and that's a point deduction. Not able to land the headshot. He scored well after being hit himself. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. An accurate left by Johnson. Johnson's putting forth that hard work he did in training camp there, landing a crisp combination.
Body shot!
Right now, he's thinking about another line of employment.
controlling throughout, but he made a good, clean finish with the knockout.
Yeah, as a trainer, you want to know, can a guy punch? Can a guy defend? You know, can a guy control distance? But you want to know, can a guy finish?
Just about ready for action. Underway. Scheduled for 10 rounds tonight between these two. He just missed that shot up top. We're underway here. We've been talking in the lead up to this fight about who has the advantage with the speed. Well, we know who that is. As for his opponent?
Well, his opponent's going to have to come up with something else. And what he's going to have to come up with is timing. You know, timing can negate speed.
How so?
Well, just making sure that before your opponent starts, you time him. You beat him to the mark. You're not as fast as him, but guess what? The good news, this is not a sprint. This is a boxing match. You can beat him to the mark. For all intents and purposes, you're faster. Get on your bicycle when you've been hurt. No, the bicycle's not there. You got flat tires. What you gotta do is grab on the inside, clear your head.
Goes up top with a right. Jones has 60 seconds to recover. Hopefully will be enough for him. Now he's got good cornering. He's got the right people in place to try to fix this situation.
Yeah, and they got to work like a pit stop, you know, in the Indianapolis 500. One guy's giving the gas, another guy's changing the tires, you know, another guy's maybe giving the driver a little water. They got to do the same thing. Give him some water, refresh him a little bit, work his legs a little bit, and then just before he goes out, a little advice.
There's another left hand from him. Tyson's out to show everybody that he's fine. But we saw, wow, impact, a short hook got to him that time. That's not going to be easy to survive. He goes from damaged goods to defensive goods.
Yeah, because right now he's fighting on instincts. He's doing things without even thinking, just automatically. Things that he was taught 5 years ago, 3 years ago, that maybe he thought about, but he didn't do. Now they're just coming out. He's just naturally surviving.
You could see what he wanted to do there, but unable to land that body shot. Teddy, we have found out time and time again in boxing that you are very much a product of where you come from. How is that the case with Mike Tyson?
Well, it's a case where a lot of...
Boy, oh boy, that's tough.
Earlier for him, it turned out to be a bad thing for his opponent because he got callous here.
Let's go, get up, Jimmy.
The ref is stopping this fight. Roy Jones Jr.'s not going to hear from those judges. He's a knockout victim. Mike Tyson's the man. One single punch, one solid knockout, that's all it took.
And I love the way he did it. He tricked him into it. He made him walk in a little bit and then bang.
Good evening, I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip. Morrison's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Keeping his hands up, getting away of his opponent's effort. If you made a checklist of advantages and disadvantages, obviously you'd want the advantage in hand speed, but you've trained many a guy who's been on the other side where his opponents have the better hand speed. What have you told him?
Well, I tell him, make it a muddy track. You know, Secretariat must be the fastest horse in the world, but on a muddy track, things change a little bit. Step out of range. Don't allow the kind of landscape, the kind of track that will suit speed.
90 seconds to go here in this round. There he goes with the right hand again.
Yeah, a lot of work because he doesn't have the benefit of his legs. Can't move around, there, wobbly right now. So what he's got to do is grab on a little bit and walk. Walk to the rope, kill some time. Make the referee come in between you and break you.
Tyson's impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Tommy Morrison's hurt bad by a right hand.
Now these two corners have to do their job after both men went out and gave everything they had. Both fighters getting tagged and hurt by the other.
Yeah, well, what you have to do now in the corner, Joe, what you're alluding to is you have to revitalize the fighter. Put some cold water on his head, on his neck, you know, get him ready for the next round and give him some good advice.
Good block there by Morrison. Well, something's got a stick. He sends the combination to the body. There's the hook. Morrison's coming out here after being knocked down in the last round. Teddy, what are some of the things you look for that will tell you he's on steady ground, that he looks fine?
Well, the first thing I look for is the base, the foundation. I mean, you look at a house, you want to see, and you want to make sure that that base is solid. There's cinder blocks there. You know, you don't want to see that.
So the knockdown scored against Mike Tyson, but his opponent may want to watch out as Tyson has steadied himself back up on his feet. Scored well with the left downstairs. Right hand, then a left hook to the head. Both land flush. He gives as well as he takes. You saw it on that exchange. Downstairs, but off target.
Body shot.
Morrison's showing you that sublime skill right now with that two-punch combo. Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head.
Body shot, body shot.
Very accurate two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Fine work with the left hand. He landed well by Tommy Morrison. Final 10 seconds of round number two. Morrison's punch is far off the target. So he scores a knockdown. Now he gets settled down.
Relax.
Gathers himself. Relax. Do you go after it? Do you get super aggressive here having had your man hurt? Or do you still have to employ a certain amount of caution?
It's kind of like being at the carnival. You know, you just hit the bullseye, and you got that big, big stuffed animal you can give to your wife or your girlfriend. But now, he doesn't want you to go away with that.
Oh, no.
No. He tells you, wait a minute, try again. You could trade that in for something even bigger. You might lose the one you have already. That's the question.
Good, smooth work by Morrison. That's classic counterpunch.
And what he did was he pulled that right shoulder back. You know, he just pulled it back, gave him the left shoulder, and then gave him the right hand.
Good body shot. The right hand came home. Morrison's combination punching is working well here.
You got this one.
Keep it going.
Comes right back with a shot. Punch combo by Tommy Morrison.
Get him.
And now we got a fight. He fires back a right hand of his own.
Yeah.
Right back to the belt line. Morrison's quickly taking control of this fight early on with one single weapon of choice, and that is the jab.
Yeah, the jab and the jab at the right time. He's catching his opponent every time he starts coming in.
Round. Bobby Morrison's putting on a show for the fans in this fight so far, but it's not the kind of show that his corner wants to see. Yes, he's up 2 rounds to 1 according to your scorecard as we start round number 4, but considering the fact that they've already traded knockdowns, anything can happen from here on out.
Yeah, but if I'm the corner, I'm taking a negative, a possible negative, I'm turning it into a positive. I'm going to tell him, hey, look, you've been down now, don't let it happen again. You know what his strengths are, don't play into them.
Doing what every trainer wants to see their fighter do. Land punches and punches. The combination lands. Now, this is exactly what I love out of an offensive fighter, Teddy. A guy who's able to put together the multi-punch combinations and make it look like he's just a sweet side.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you can do. Not just good physical ability. That's only part of the equation. But just good technical ability. And that's what he's doing. He's snapping his punches. They're nice and clean. They're crisp. They're short. They're together.
Snapping jabs by Mike Tyson. Targeting the left hand to the body. Oh, he is stuck. He could go down. Referee gives him a warning for headbutting. Tyson's being damaged right now. Punch after punch is coming in. Oh! And he crashes to the canvas once again. He's gotten up before. What about this time? Tyson's corner needs to really give him a hand after this round. They need to treat him after that knockdown. They also need to give him some sound advice. What's the advice you give him?
Well, first of all, if they're going to get the chance to get to him, he better move his head. But the advice I would give him is, hey, you go out this next round and you kill some guy. Tie him up a little bit right from the beginning. Don't worry about losing the early part of the fight or the early part of the round. Just get yourself back together.
Round number 5 has arrived.
Do you see any way in which he can take his opponent's aggression and turn it against him?
Yeah, the perfect way. I mean, boxing 101, counterpunching. You got a guy coming at you, no better way than to change his mind. Make him miss, make him pay.
Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand. Tyson's so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. Took a go of it to the body, but came up empty. Able to land the jab.
Keep doing what you're doing. Don't hurt him. Kick move.
Halfway into round number 5 here.
Let's go, hit him.
That's an intense jab right there by Mike Tyson.
As if he's been taught, have good habits, have good fundamentals been put there. You're going to find out right now. He needs them right now.
Mike Tyson's losing a point here. He headbutted again. The referee's seen enough. He's taken away a point.
Mike Tyson's killing me watching him here. I mean, he doesn't need a 20-by-20 ring. He could fight this thing in like a phone booth.
Now, he looks like one of those cars you see on the side of the road where they remove all the tires, all the wheels. He's not going anywhere.
The start of the 6th round.
Morrison's gonna just try to keep doing exactly what he did the entire first half of this fight. He put forth a game plan he noticed early on in training camp, and it's worked to perfection. Nice job snapping those jabs by Morrison.
Look at the little subtleties here, Joe. What he does is he forces them into a position to stop the punch. And then when he stops, steps back, makes a miss, and comes right back.
Solid right by Mike Tyson. A good block. Left hook, right hand, well done, especially to the body. Got to figure out a way to do something different here. I mean, I know he's committed to being a contender, but right now he's giving rounds away.
Yeah, he is, because he's waiting for things to happen that are not happening. You know, he's laying back, he's waiting for the guy to walk in. See, to be a good counterpuncher, an effective counterpuncher, guy has to come close to him. But his opponent's staying at a distance. He's not giving him anything to counter.
He gets hit, but he gives it right back. Landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Morrison's training is zero right now between rounds. Said, hey, you've never seen anything like the way he works a double end back. It's proven true.
Yeah, it has. You know, part of why he's so accurate is his pump, but part of it is he works on it like you just said. He gets on that crazy bag, that double end bag, and he makes sure that those punches are right on the mark. His trainer was even telling him.
Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas. Good evening and welcome to the State Palace Theater. Great venue here. First round underway of the scheduled time. Tyson's power has been shown off early on in his fights. Teddy, what effect could his power have early in this fight?
Well, if he catches his opponent, it could be an early night. But if he catches his opponent survives it, guess what? It could be a long night, fam.
Wow.
Why is he doing this? Can you explain this right here? I mean, he's not doing anything.
Either he's been hurt where we didn't see the punch early on, or right now he's thinking about getting out of there. He just doesn't want to fight anymore. He's broken down.
Halfway through this round here.
Uppercut.
Something for his opponent after getting tagged.
Kick those hands up.
And now another left.
Tyson's
proving to be elusive. Big shot. Combination puts him down. Ali's wish came true. He was hoping for the impact round. Now he has it. That was the only thing stopping him from going down.
Yeah, but it's not over. You know, you have to think like a fighter thinks. Yeah, for that moment, he got a reprieve. But he's got to go back in 1 minute and face it again. Does he have the wherewithal to do that?
Tyson's right hand scores well. Committing to the work downstairs with the left. Muhammad Ali is making me question how his legs are right now. I'm not sure that he's all too secure and steady on those legs after that knockdown, just like he's tying up a lot here.
Yeah, well, you don't have to wonder. You're saying you're not so sure he's secure. Well, he's telling you. You know, he's right there. That's about as honest of a fight as ever going to be is when he's clinching. He's telling you, I don't feel too good.
Resourceful 1-2 combo by Mike Tyson. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Now he's resorting to dirty tactics, and now he's got to be careful because he's in a big shot. Oh, is this good stuff? What good stuff? He just scored the knockdown after being knocked down earlier.
Well, that's incredible. And the knockdown earlier actually set up this knockdown. He got a little reckless, a little careless.
He went down from a big shot. Now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're going to find out exactly what he's made of.
Tyson's hitting the mark right now. How precise was he there with that three-punch combo? Not hitting his mark there.
The mentality of a fighter, because he's got to go back and face that in a minute when he comes out of his corner. Can he face that? Can he push that away out of his consciousness?
Seems like he's clinching a little more now. He was stunned earlier in this fight, Kenny. So could this be a case of him trying to find a way to buy himself some time and steady himself a bit?
And that's exactly what he's trying to do. And his opponent has to take advantage. On the inside, rotate his shoulders back, create a loop.
And from long range, he's able to get his target he wanted.
And when you have somebody throwing long punches, what you don't want to do is what he did. Pull back straight.
Tyson's put forth a boom, 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 a three-punch combination score.